Have you ever been walking down the street, riding on a bus, or taken part in any other form of metaphorical locomotion, looked down at your own hand and started anxiously sweating at the thought of all the weird, moving, biological things happening beneath your own flesh? Well, whilst many of you would just shrug off that thought on a need-to-know basis, some of you would have instead screamed out in existential torment in a moment charged with double entendre, crying out into the sky, "What am I? What am I made of? What are all these moving parts, and how is this passive biological magic happening?" Okay. Maybe that's a slight over-exaggeration, but hey, stay with me. Hello internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what if our bodies were transparent? Roll the clip.
But you're still here.
It's not even my brain.
Alright guys, okay, don't worry, perhaps that may be a slight exaggeration, but for the curious amongst you, that scene was from 2014's RoboCop, which isn't a touch on the original, but nevertheless, that scene is quite something, right? And hey, come on, there isn't exactly an abundance of transparent and or translucent bodies in cinema, so we'll have to suffice with some state-of-the-art bioengineering to do the trick. And evidently, it leads us to a very interesting point, one that will be our jumping off platform for this particular Life's Biggest Question, and that is, why aren't our bodies transparent already? But before we do that, it's definitely important that we spell out the linguistics of this keyword in particular, as compared to its two interconnected counterparts, one of which often gets confused with the other, opaque and translucent. Now, transparency, although as obvious it may seem, is when one can relatively see an object on the other side of a solid body. On the other hand, opacity is when that passage of light is all but barred, and translucency, the odd one out, is when light passes relatively easy through a solid object, but not so that an object on the other side can be made out by the viewer. And as you may imagine, for the most part, our human skin is very much opaque, but there are exceptions to that rule, so hold on to that thought. Because let's first take a look at everyone's favourite subject, evolution, which may give us a bit of a clearer idea as to how we can best approach this hypothetical notion. And yes, that pun was indeed intended. Now, as we all know, life on Earth is a majestic thing. The relentless force of life finding its way throughout millennia has produced some incredible feats of biology and anatomy, and we need only look through the wondrous landscape of the animal kingdom to find some equally incredible transparent bodies. And while, yes, pretty much all of them reside in the deep, dark bowels of the ocean, because as we all know, that's where things get a little bit weird. But in fact, in the deep blue sea, as you may imagine, transparency is the ultimate camouflage, and that particularly intriguing trait, for the most part, has allowed these creatures to flourish in an otherwise inhospitable landscape. Perhaps the most ingenious of these is the glass octopus, one of the most mysterious sea creatures in the ocean, and that's saying something. Thanks to nearly all of its body being transparent, the elusive glass octopus has managed to evade predators by turning itself almost completely invisible in its marine home, with only its digestive organs and cylindrical eye being the opaque parts of its body. In an underwater realm where there is little to no light, the ability to literally become the landscape is one of evolution's greatest blessings for the glass octopus, and this necessitates the evolutionary need to become transparent. The same applies to many other creatures in the animal kingdom, the glass frogs of Central and South America, the moon jellyfish, the ironically named sea walnut, glass-winged butterflies, ghost shrimp, the Antarctic ice fish. All of them are ingenious displays of biological and evolutionary transparency. You can even see it in the majority of marine life at the beginning stages of their life. Small, tiny fish babies are often completely transparent before their chromatic hue sets in, seemingly to keep them out of the eyes of predators before they can grow big and strong. And yet, this necessity is the key component to one thing. All of these creatures fall into the unfortunate category of being prey, as none of them use this evolutionary tactic for predatory purposes. Now, as a separate side note, that's not to say that there aren't any transparent predators, because as we all know, the ocean is a deep and mysterious place, and we have no idea what the hell is lurking down there. So, yeah. Food for thought, I guess. But as you may have guessed it, all of this points to one thing. In this hypothetical notion, if our bodies were transparent, that would likely only occur under one specific set of circumstances. Our species, known as Homo sapien, must have evolved as the prey to some kind of other predatory animals. Now, obviously, we're casting aside all of the biological facts that have gotten our species this far, but hey, evolution is a random set of sporadic mutations, and who knows, in some alternate reality, our species may already be transparent creatures living in some vast, secret, interconnected network of jungle cities, evading an all-powerful civilization of sentient birds that dominate the skies in an empire of towering technological bird nests. Ah, that's a pretty crazy thought, isn't it? But hey, that's the wonder of speculative science fiction. Thank you, imagination. Now that we've given these parameters, we can only imagine what kind of baffling quirks would come with being able to see through your own body, for the most part anyway. Perhaps the most adverse effect to having transparent skin would be the immediate exposure to sunlight and all of the damaging consequences of having our muscles and blood exposed to direct ultraviolet rays that come with it. Under this hypothetical situation, though, it's safe to assume that evolution has once again played its part, and much like the Antarctic ice fish, a species of fish which sequesters the hemoglobin in its blood so that it can survive in the frigid depths of the frozen south, we can imagine our blood and muscle tissue developing some equally similar adaptability to radiation. Hopefully, anyway, else we'd all be toast. Anatomically speaking, we can also assume that there's been a slight rearrangement in terms of bone structure and organ placement. Obviously, as a transparent, non-predatory species, our bone density would have taken a hit, and perhaps down to that, we'd have become much smaller humanoids than we are now, as the critical weight of what our bone structure could carry gradually diminished. On that note, we can also imagine that our network of organs would perhaps be less widespread, occurring in a centralized cluster similar to the glass frogs of South America, although it's entirely possible that our organs themselves would have developed to be translucent, if not entirely transparent. Obviously, we could also assume that culturally speaking, we'd have developed a much more intimate appreciation for the biology of our own bodies. The ability to take a look under the hood, so to speak, may have resonated throughout the ages as our speculative species developed their own societies and cultures, and a reverence for the internal components of our bodies would have played an integral part in the foundation of civilization. For the most part, toxins such as alcohol and tobacco may have been completely shunned by our fictional species, as the internal visual of a set of tar-ridden lungs and a dead and shriveled liver may have been too much to stomach. But we could even go one further and say that food and substances that produced particularly pleasant hues within our internal structures would be highly sought after, perhaps even acting as some form of social status. Pass me the strawberries. If our bodies were transparent, it would have meant that somewhere along the evolutionary timeline, just before we crawled out of the primordial ooze of the oceans, the benefits of some form of transparent amphibian evading predators on land traveled through to a mammalian species and eventually found its way to Homo sapiens. Obviously, it's an incredibly specific set of circumstances, but hey, that's evolutionary mutation for you, isn't it? But there is one question that still remains to be answered. If your bodies were transparent, would we wear clothes? I mean, I think it's probably for the best, isn't it? Well, there we have it, our long and short answer to the question, what if our bodies were transparent? If they were, it would have meant that our species took an overwhelmingly different evolutionary path than what our given ancestors did. But hey, eating bright colored foods would be fun. What do you guys think? Do you agree with the way that we see it? Do you have any more interesting insights to add? Then please let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below. Before we depart from today's video though, let's first take a quick look at some of your more creative comments from over the past few days. First up, Kyra MBL says, hello, is there anybody in there? Yeah, pal, there is, just not if you can hear me. Next up, Ed Flynn says, time flies like an arrow, fruit flies like a banana. You're a funny man, Ed. Keep it up. And finally, Hugh Janus says, hey, can you like my comment just for the sake of it? Well, I can do you one better, Hugh Janus, and I can read it out. Oh, wait, I see what you did there. Yeah, right, next you're going to tell me that your name is really Seymour Butts or something. Yeah, I'm not going to fall for that one. Well, on that most Lizak note, unfortunately, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Just sticking around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video, or just Life's Biggest Questions in general, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe bell. And I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. Until next time, you take it easy.